Hello, internet friends, and welcome back to another episode of Bay's Adventure and Heroes of the Storm. Heroes League, we were just sitting here chatting after the game, and all of a sudden the queue just pops way earlier than the last one. I'm sitting down here again with Mr. SolidJake. Hello, sir.
What's up, man? Glad to be back.
Sadly, we lost on Hump Day.
We did.
That was a barn burner of a game, though. Holy crap. We're also first pick again on Blackhearts Bay. What? I mean, I'll take it. We should play Cho'Gall, obviously, right?
Oh, gosh. We can.
What is your professional caster opinion of Cho'Gall?
He's actually much better and much more viable in this patch. The changes they made to the talent tiers and just the damage in general. Completely viable and a decent hero, but not a good first pick, in my opinion. Mm. Too many counters.
So they picked Li Ming, so what are you thinking?
I'm thinking we should take Kael'thas.
Do you want him, or do you want me to take him, or what do you want to do?
I'll take Tyrande. Oh, it looks like we have a guy hovering Rhaegar. I could take Thrall.
You could definitely take Thrall.
Actually, no, I'd go Za'Gara. Za'Gara's really good on this map, the solo lane.
I could take Thrall then. That's not Thrall. Okay. That's not Thrall. This is Thrall.
If you want Thrall, I'll take KT.
I mean, I could play Za'Gara. She is another one. What do you want to do? You want to play Za'Gara?
I'll just play Za'Gara then. Yeah, we'll do that.
I'll play Thrall?
Yeah.
Okay.
So the nice thing about locking in the two of them is, well, they're both really strong because you can land big combos. Like, you think about Maw paired with Sundering. If you can pair those together, mm-hmm. It can be absolutely amazing. But the other really cool thing is you have the two strongest laners in the game, essentially. Like, they're probably individually each the strongest laners. And you might be playing Thrall and say, well, he doesn't seem that strong in lane. If you spec into Chain Lightning at level 1, level 4, and you play very passively and poke, it just slowly whittle your opponents down.
Oh, absolutely. Yep. Oh, absolutely. Depending on their... Wow, they went double mage. Yeah, I mean, rolling Thunder and Ride the Lightning are both great. Even though, at 4... Depending on what they want to pick for frontline, I might take in Venom, but we'll have to see.
It's strong. I mean, they did get. That's kind of why I was thinking Kael'thas would be good for us, just because giving them Kael'thas Li Ming was so rough in that game.
Fair. At that last game, yeah, it's very true. But really strong. We are. Some of them is hovering the Stitches, which Stitches is really good against Kael'thas.
He is. It's pretty against Li Ming as well.
Just gonna make sure that she doesn't have her blink up when you hook her in. Oh, another Vala. Oh, just pick Jim. Pick Jim. Vala is so much more technically complicated than Jim, and Jim is just a lot more safe. Oh, don't. I mean, I'm okay with it because our Vala last game did a lot of damage. Oh, okay, fine. So, yeah, I was talking about talent stuff. So they picked Sonya, and why I was saying about instant or in Venom. What are your thoughts on in Venom on Thrall? Because I would in Venom Sonya every time she comes in, and it counters a lot of her healing initially.
It depends on the way you want to look at it. If you look at a standard Thrall, and Venom is really just going to give you more potential to get early game kills. Okay. So if you think the layout of the game actually is just kind of saying, all right, well, we have a stronger early game, then we can pick them off a lot, then it's totally worth it. If you find yourself in lane against someone like Li Ming, that could definitely be the edge you need to kill Li Ming a few times, you know, early in the game.
Oh, well, my counter to that, too, what I was curious about is Spirit Journey. I've had some success on Spirit Journey, which is the range on Feral Spirit. Really good for picking off those straggler mages.
If you have a multi-stun composition, I think there's a little bit more viability for that.
Okay. Yeah, we only have a stun right now.
Yeah, I'd probably go for an upgrade for your Chain Lightning or Infinim.
Just for giving us poke, because we don't have a ton of poke right now. Yeah, you're good. You're right. So they went with Zeratul as their third assassin pick. So we're up the same situation where we're double assassin specialist or triple assassin.
Yeah.
Which, in lower ranks, when I was ranking up to, like, the 15, 16s where I am now, I actually experienced that playing either against or with Triple Assassin is incredibly tumultuous. Which, I don't know how else to describe it, because either, you win really handily, or, like, you sort of, like, slowly lose. I don't know how to explain. I mean, last game, the other enemy team could have technically lost with Triple Assassin, right? But...
They definitely could. This is going to be really tough for us because Zeratul is an incredibly smart pick. They have double mage, which are going to get us very low in health. They're just going to burn us from afar, and Zeratul can pick us off when we're low going into the back line. So it's going to be a tough game for us, that's for sure.
Would you? I'm thinking what would Stitches pick to counter that? And I want to say he could pick the, what's the bile, the poop on the ground? I never play Stitches.
Bile's great disengage, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I hope he goes Putrid Bile. Definitely the better heroic in the situation.
Because I was wondering if he would take the Chomp Chomp, the eat, because he could just eat Zeratul when he jumps in, like, immediately, if he could. I mean, depending on where he is in the map, but I don't know. I don't know how it just plays now, because he was buffed a lot.
The thing is, if Zeratul still has Blink ready, usually the eat's not going to be that beneficial. So you have to be very careful with it and use it in situations where Zeratul doesn't have Blink available. All right, well, Zagara, very strong bottom laner, so I'm just going to set a creep here myself. She's just like the queen of bottom lane on Blackhearts Bay. You always want to have lots of vision.
We are a little bit overly zealously fighting over the mid here, and we should not be for any reason other than it's a waste of time, and soaking is more important than even a kill worth of XP. Wow, they have four mid.
They're going ham, aren't they?
Yeah, I have four mid. Not sure. I burned so much mana on this early engage to like get no damage down.
Feels bad, man.
Just because they have Karazim mid with Sonya just getting totally healed up. Oh, he missed the hook. That hook miss was pretty bad. It's like a point black hook that just and Vala got roped in. Chained in, rather. Did you get the... You can't take that from him, can you?
It's going to be tough. This Kael'thas is pulling me pretty hard.
We're rotating down two people. Okay, we can get three. Oh, they're going to rotate here, too. I bet they're going to be right here in this bush. Oh, the hook miss. I guess that's fair. That was a long way. You got three? Okay. But we have no one soaking the whole wave top now.
Yeah, that's not ideal.
No, I'm not thinking that is. So... This game loaded and got picked a little bit faster, but... Ooh, my goodness. I was going to have you plug yourself again, for those of you who don't know who you are and what you do on the internet, and why should people care about the things coming out of your mouth?
I'm a professional Heroes commentator. Oh, my goodness, and I'm a professional Dead Heroes commentator.
Oh, no!
Kael'thas leaving. They were waiting for my rotation, didn't...
They were in the boxes, I saw that.
Yeah. I cast Heroes of the Storm and make a lot of content for the game. And I study pro players all the time. That's pretty much what I do.
Who were you last studying from who was the last pro player you were studying? Words.
It's more teams and players, but I've just really been taking a look at what we're seeing out of Team Blaze lately. Oh, they're going for a very early camp here in bottom. Very aggressive rotations.
Oh, I see them down there, yeah. Well, they have a lot of AoE damage, so...
Yeah, we are having a bad start.
The Stitches, I don't think he's hooked but once. Which is not trying to maybe, like, throw in shade, as the kids say nowadays, but, I mean, it's very apparent that he's getting dodged quite often. There's three down here with you two.
Yeah, Firelord on Sonya, she rooted it up. Sonya, Zeratul was around as well, so...
Yeah, that's why I was saying three. I couldn't see him, obviously, though. I don't know. This is a weird team comp. I mean, we have a lot of possible wombo with you and me. So, like, you set me up with.
Yeah, we definitely can do it.
Right.
We're going to need to get picks eventually.
Man, this... Ooh, I don't know if... Oh, I got flipped in somehow. What was that all about? Oh, the S of Cho she just got. That's a good point. You go Wind Fury build on Thrall too? Like you go the Wind Fury cooldown, Wind Fury hits?
13, 16, yeah, I grab the talents.
Ooh.
Sometimes level 7.
Got a pick on... No, we did not get a pick on Zeratul. Did he take the extra blink talent?
Vorpal Blade or...
Nope, he took... He has Regen Master and Gathering Power.
Okay, Sonya and Kael'thas both bottom.
Oh, we almost got a pick on him again.
with Merc Lord. Sonya's like just murking hard and pushing.
Oh, they got a pick on the overzealous Katazim. Probably gonna get a lot of siege damage done here with me and Vala right now in mid. Does the extra stacks of Frost Wolf work now?
I actually don't know. I haven't tested it.
I think it did. I tested a quick match. I think it works. I know people told me before, like, Bay, why are you taking, what's it called, at 13, yeah, Grace of Air. Like, why are you taking that? It doesn't work right now. And I was like, I mean, that's a huge push down here. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. Sonya's really low.
I could flank Sonya. Got her. And he should be dead. I'm going to body block in front. And he is boomked. There we go. That's good.
Very good.
Shaman Brothers, Rhaegar and Thrall.
The Orc Boys.
They actually really synergize pretty well together, too, not just because they're orcs.
No, in this patch in particular, yeah, they're a great pair.
Yeah, just the Earthbind plus the Root and the setup and the Lightning Shield nonsense, and yeah. Going to get Giants for you, Zag. Okay. What a bro. Yeah, I think they... Do you think they are going to nerf Rhaegar's Lightning Shield?
I think they'll probably nerf Love 16 talent.
That does more damage per hit?
Yeah. I think that's really the key strength of it. That might be too much. Okay, Vala's got to back out of here. Is there, there's three, four.
Yeah, there's two. There's three. One top. The one's rotating from top. I have a lot. I can't die. I have freaking five.
Yeah, I am just getting some mana from Rapid Incubation right now.
Oh, they are all over Stitches, and he is probably dead. We can't go in on that right now. I can't afford to die right now because I have our turn in. Oh gosh.
Not good. Not a good attempt.
Yep. Oh, we lost our sippy cup down here.
I know, it's been troubling me for a while now.
Rhaegar did not take damage.
We'll get 10 just about from those towers going down.
Almost. They're turning in right now. One, they only have one. Where are they right now? Behind you? Oh,
back up. They probably rotating from mid.
Yep. I saw them in the fog. I saw their foot. So here's 10. Got that sundering though. Are we gonna fight this? If he gets hook, I'm gonna fight this. Oh, he got it.
Nice.
I said if you got the hook, I'm fighting this.
That's beautiful.
I'm not even gonna wait. Here's the Storm is a game of seconds.
It literal. Is. Man. They just got heroics.
Yes, but we can turn in now. Oh, I'm gonna. Oh my gosh, the hooks. Okay, he had to warm up.
And now he's in there. Nice blink from that Zeratul.
Yeah, he jumped over the wall. I jumped over the shark, I think. We can back to back turn in if I don't die. I think seven. We have eight. We have nine. Oh crap, Zeratul's down here. Oh, I'm dead. Yep.
So
he rotated on me. Yep. No, and Kael'thas here too. He blinked down and did not go to his base, and he did die. Oh, you got a... There's three there. I don't know, Rhaegar feels like a hero that we deserve, but not the hero we need. You've got Vala there too. Just took Strafe. That's a double kill. That's definitely a double kill. That's yours. Okay, well, alright. Should I type hashtag worth in chat?
Yeah, man. That's the dream.
I'm gonna go top and soak and kill these mercs, okay? Because yeah. I have no coins now anyway.
So you'll notice I did something weird there, and it's not something a lot of people do.
Can I actually answer what you said, because I'm a Zagara player myself?
Oh, okay.
You put that there to block terrain, so they had to funnel into the lightning shielded Rhaegar.
Pretty much.
Okay. Yeah, I've actually whiffed ults on purpose before. People are like, what are you doing, Bay? You suck. They got the boss, by the way. I just looked over, and there's a boss coming at me. But yeah, you can use Maw. I mean, sometimes it's a happy accident if you miss and you just make terrain, but I want to make sure that's what you did, because I'm like an idiot.
Yeah, that's exactly what it was, man.
Okay.
I used it as a force wall, essentially.
Yeah. A very long cooldown force wall.
So, but it worked, man. We got the kills, we got the coins, they got the boss. That Merc Sonya is really weird. Oh, Kael'thas pickoff. Really nice, and they also got Lee.
Oh!
Yeah,
I'm beating on this boss here. I keep looking at the map and keep messing up my micro and keep getting stunned. So, you know, that's good. Too bad I'm Thrall. I don't get hurt. It's okay. Yeah, I'm gonna take Grace of Air and see if it works, and in YouTube comments they'll be like, "You're so dumb, Bay, it doesn't work." I think it's working. Maybe. I just got two heals.
I almost always go Mutalisk, but I'm respecting the double mage and I went Spell Shield.
Really?
Yep.
Wow. I don't think I've ever taken Spell Shield on all my Zagara play. I think she's my most played champion. Most wins in ranked is definitely Zagara. Which, we can take these, yeah? We can take these, Vela, that's sure. One, two, three. Yeah, I got a full heal off of one Wind Fury, so that was definitely gaining.
Nice. Yeah, that's good.
Full stacks. Okay, it works. It was broken for a while. I think people were telling me to call. Oh! Nice Maw. But Stitches is dead. I saw that at the corner of my screen here looking at the minimap. Oh, man, it's.
They're gonna turn in.
They have 12. They need one to turn in. Yeah, we can't even, like, poke them off of that. Oh, you big boy!
Yeah, I'm ham. Oh, nice Sundering!
Oh, he saved my life, technically. Sonya is here, though. I don't know if we can fight this. I'm gonna sneak out.
Oh, I am. I'm a dead sandwich, man.
You're a dead sandwich?
The big dead sandwich. Banelings, go out! Trade!
We got valiantly. Trade valiantly, yeah, you mean one for one. They got the coins, though. They only have five left. I think we gained. Oh, Who grabbed?
They just went up alone.
No, what? No. He doesn't have anything. Who grabbed all their coins? Did Vala do it? Yeah, I know. Who has all the coins?
11 on Zeratul.
Yeah, okay. Damn it. The Bambling Trade. We are 9-7. We're up by 2 kills again. But this time we at least have a keep advantage. Last game we did not.
We have big experience advantage, and the mercs that, like, even though that fight was in their favor and we lost some coins, the damage tons structures, like, bottom towers are down. Like, that's huge.
Yeah.
You can't undervalue that kind of stuff.
They're already over here, see? That's the mercs we just killed before you guys were dying. We gotta pick mid. No. I don't have a mana. What am I doing? I need to go get a cup. Oh, bottom chest. Should I go to bottom chest?
It should be safe.
Well, yeah, no one's there, I don't think. Because I saw Kel'Thas in base. This will be enough for... Okay, we're all here now. Ooh, okay, what's up, team? Do you... See, like, I'm watching right now, like, my team, like, they just wanted to go pick up coins. In pro play, you try to, like, make, like, maybe two people pick up coins, right? Because you don't want to have, like, you have four people right now all channeling. Like, is that bad?
It's bad against some things. Oh, that was so close. But in this composition, I think it's fine.
Yeah.
Generally speaking, it's not that risky.
Is he dead?
Should be.
Wait. Oh, I was going to chain lightning from the turret to him. That's okay. We got 16s off of that.
Sonya, Mantle's Punisher?
Yeah, I need to get mana. I guess I'm okay. I'll cut her off. Oh, I see you. Yeah, you're going the same way I'm going. She's going to go way north. Oh, no, there she is. I knocked her off. Oh!
Oh!
I wish I had the first talent to give me the more range. I predicted it. Yeah, you can't chase. They're going to be behind you. Or beside you. Are you going? I'm going to go back and kill these mercs with Vala, because we have three waves pushing in our top lane right now.
Yeah.
Are we? Okay, there you are. Okay, I was like, wait, where did we go? So what has been your, like, largest event you've cast? You think with BlizzCon, you think?
Yeah, definitely.
Last year?
It was like over 100,000 people, so.
That was a bit of a hiccup at this past year's BlizzCon with the Heroes stuff.
A delay? The big long delay?
The super delay? Yeah.
Fortunately, I wasn't on the cast at that time. They stalled for like 3 hours. It sounds absolutely brutal. Mm-hmm. But yeah, no, that was rough. I mean, delay the whole tournament.
Here they are. I'm not near. Oh, nice freaking Maw. I'm going to flank them.
I'm going to die. They dove on me really quick. Yeah, that's harsh. We're too split. Just retreat.
Yep. I couldn't get there because they went down when I wanted to go across. They got double merc camps down here pushing.
Yeah, this merc Sonya is working out pretty well for them, honestly. It's a weird, unorthodox style for sure, but they've
Oh, she took Merc Commander? Oh, I'm dead. Oh,
Sonya's in. Oh no, Sonya the wrong way.
I tried to hit it after the cast time. I turned my mouse at the cast time. I was looking at the score screen, backing up, because I wanted to see what you said. I derped. Yeah, she took Mercenary Lord. Yeah, wow.
Oh, this is going to be rough.
Yeah, I definitely,
Way too long. She might die. Is Vala? She's not careful. Okay.
Yeah, the mercs can actually kill her.
Oh yeah.
They cannot turn in yet, and there's not enough. There are 2, 4, 6, 8 on the map. If they killed every merc camp. Yeah. So that was pretty dumb of me. I was one of my second death. I derped.
That's all good. I was not free yet, but we did lose two keeps.
The bottom end that one. The inner. They're a one keep advantage now. We need this boss, I think. Oh, they're there. Sonya's already there. Sonya may sneak again.
Yeah, she's top. But we can get a turn.
We're level-ish below. No, they're all mid. They're just.
We need to fight before 20, so. Fighting now is a good idea, actually.
The hook missed. Missing was really rough. I would have sundered that hook. Oh, we're split. Vala split. Oh, you're there too.
Had to mob, unfortunately.
Zeratul's down here. Yeah, we kind of need to wait for a he's right here. I saw him. We're kind of all split again.
Yeah.
I don't know if I'm splitting the right incorrectly, or the team keeps staying up when they're pushing us that way. Oh, what the heck? What? Oh, can we get to him?
Oh, no. Thundering? Nice.
I waited out that Divine Palm like a champion with my last auto attack to hit 3 times. Oh, that was actually pretty good of me. I will pat myself on the back for that. Woo! We have 24 coins. We got to turn in and get that boss. Let's get this and get the boss. I'm going to go start the boss. I don't need to turn in.
Yeah, we got enough on Rhaegar alone.
Woohoo!
We are in it.
Nope.
And that was crucial because if we didn't get that fight before level 20, we would have had Storm Talents.
Yeah.
So we needed that fight. It was actually very foolish for the enemy team to look for the
chase
fight.
Chase us?
Yeah. Yeah, it was a little bit foolish, but hey, man, your Sundering clutched it out.
Sorry, I mean, I'm playing a little bit above a weight class because I'm only like 15, 16. So I feel like I have to like, people were criticizing my Karazim play I did with Forecourt. They're like, you play so passive. You had a really great 7-sided strike pick, but you just like sat around and like auto attacked minions for a long time and like just played like a bitch. And I was like, yeah, I'm playing against level ones. I'm playing like a bitch. So I thought that's the better course of action there is don't. And that's why I've only died twice on Thrall, which Thrall can definitely get picked and die a lot.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
So, I don't know. So do you take Worldbreaker or Nexus Blades or both of the Storm, you think, on Thrall?
I go Bolt. It's good to have an escape.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I'll take Bolt. I don't normally.
Just think about late game deaths and how long they are and how impactful they are. So if you can pretty much prevent yourself from dying in almost any situation with Bolt, it's really, really good. And it's good for chasing in some situations too, which can also win games.
What does buy then push bot with siege? What's the guy saying buy for?
You Where can't, are they?
Nothing to buy. They can't turn in. We can turn in though.
Leaping's at top.
We can definitely turn in then. She can't poke us down. I have 2. I should turn in 2. That's 12. Oh, so she says 8. We can get there. Siege 2 during the push. Maybe. Oh, hello. Piece of candy? Piece of candy?
Big.
Piece of candy! Oh, I bolted over this Kael'thas. He's gonna bolt over me, probably. No, he's dead! Oh, wow. I didn't flub the ult, Jake!
A beautiful man. That was actually a beautiful fight.
And I pushed him against the wall, too. I mean, some Thrall just like aim Sundering like right at the enemy, and you can't debate it. Aim like above or below them. What happened? Oh God!
Well, no. Me.
No! No! Oh. I'll tell the story to your people.
I didn't realize we backed up. We should have pushed bottom keep.
Well, we went to kill the mercs. They're pushing our
way. Yeah, but we could have just killed the bottom keep.
That's true. No. I may have been talking about my Sundering and sniffing my own farts for a minute there. My bad.
I actually don't have game sounds on, so it's kind of disorienting.
Really?
Well, it's because you would hear them with the way my mic setup is.
Oh,
so
that's right.
I had to turn all my game sounds off, and it's really disorienting, like,
oh,
for this kind of
weird
thing. Just kind of autopilot.
You're a beast playing without
good,
game sounds.
That was a nice hook, so if we can get him, the feral lunge and the totem, now he gets out.
I'm going to get collapsed on some. Nope, she tried to.
Okay.
Can we turn it again? We have 15. No, we cannot. We need a little bit more. I should probably get these all in, though. Wild Goose Chase? No, I know. Stitches! Don't get picked on. They have 5. Stitches!
Okay, that's 10 in. It's good, but I'm still not there. This is a 4v5. Nice Sundering. Really good. Oh, my goodness. The Divine Palm, though, that was clutch. Beautiful Ancestral. We can actually take this 4v5. Well done, guys. If you have chain lightning or anything, just throw it. Oh, Feral Lunge for the kill. Bala's cleaning it up. Yeah, nice job. You guys just took a 4v5 and we can go end the game.
Oh, my butt, my micro there. I couldn't say anything because I was like, okay, I can't wait. I gotta wait for cooldowns. I gotta wait for, I gotta dodge the Zeratul. Zeratul didn't follow me. Okay, I'm good. Wow. No problem. Just push past the mercenaries or push with you?
I just wanted to clean this up. At this point, with only 3 of us and no heals, it's kind of risky to dive on core. Core hits a lot.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't say dive core. My goodness. We don't have Artosis casting our game. We can't go ham on the core. Artosis and Tasis, rather. Yeah. It's going ham! Oh, my goodness. Are you going to have anything with the next Heroes of the Dorm, by the chance?
What's up?
Are you going to do anything with the Heroes of the Dorm this season coming up by chance, or no?
I certainly hope so, but I do not know.
Do you have to get, like, contacted, or do you, like, contact in and put your name in a hat, or how does that work, actually?
These are all gigs that they reach out for. They have my contact, and every time they'll contract me, essentially, for a gig, and it's just the same for every event, really. Some commentators have, like, managers of some form, and other commentators are strictly full-blown freelance like me.
Okay. Yeah, I was worried about that for a while because for League of Legends, I don't know how familiar you are with the LCS scene. And the one thing I think that Heroes definitely needs to benefit from is having, which they don't have the money for yet, or the, what's it called? I guess the facilities or what. But League has the casters, 2 casters, a major rotate out every couple of games, and then they have the analyst desk. So they can set up the game with one group and then toss it off to the other. Ooh, because Heroes...
Yeah. We did that for one of the broadcasts in Europe, actually, the European finals.
Oh, we're dead. Wow.
Two-man maw.
I got a huge Sundering there. I guess we couldn't follow up because I didn't hit Li Ming.
We might have just lost the game.
Maybe. I was trying to talk and ask questions, and I thought I had a really good Sunder there.
It was good. Can they turn in? They can. Does it end game? No. Can they dive after? Yes.
We have a huge wave.
Go back.
2 went back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think we lost.
I mean, their core is almost dead. That was interesting that we...
Yeah, I didn't like that call. I was creeping up and
went straight in with Stitches there, so I just followed the team.
Huh? Yeah.
I don't know. Interesting.
I didn't think we were going to
push for end.
They
should.
I wasn't in position for the fight. I had to rush in and immediately got VP'd. They're diving.
I should have. Really? I should have. Well, we have people coming up. They could throw the game right here. I'm up right now.
Yeah, we're not necessarily dead.
What if they get like a pick? I mean, just push their core.
Oh man. All right, yeah, we're fine. We're fine. Didn't even take core damage. It's massive.
Yeah, they're at 35. Zeratul's chunked as well. Rhaegar chunked him out, so he's not here right now. And Kael'thas is defending. Oh, are we chasing this? Are you chasing this? They have boss up. They have boss?
Boss is too risky. We can just dive in the core.
They can't turn in. They can turn in. Not. Oh, I saw that. Oh!
Come on, me.
I can't follow anything up yet. They had a little bomb on me. We did get Li Ming.
We can end. We just need Fala to not die right now.
I just healed her a little bit. Sonya at boss?
Who cares? We can end the game.
Ooh, we get a little tense.
Yeah, I'm tense, man. I want to win this game. Nice.
Yeah, I had to do all that fancy footwork. Kael'thas is in to win it right now. Who'd you get?
KG, just denied him his damage.
Woo!
Oh, we did it, yes!
Both of us, nice. Like, stopped talking immediately. There was no commentating whatsoever.
We were just like
okay. micro, yeah. Woo!
The well victor. Then. That's the norm for your pattern, right? Lose, win?
I mean, what's my, I have to go back up to my stats. I think I'm actually a little higher than a 50-50. Because I've played now 94 games, and I've won, I think, 61. That doesn't include placements. So.
That's pretty good.
Yeah. Woo, we are doing this. All right, so there's the stat screen. People always wonder the stat screen. I did too bad. Valid did tons of damage. That made Kael'thas 95k. Oof.
Yeah, KT hurt that game. The Li Ming didn't do... She really wasn't scary compared to like some of the other... Leamings that we do see, because he was playing very passively. He knew the big power potential that existed from like the power of Thrall going in, and you picked her off a good number of times with Sunderings.
Yeah, except that one that I fired the wrong direction, but don't. That is, I'm gonna edit that out in post. Yeah. So, did you have what do you think about talents though? We have going on here for more talent talk builds.
Yeah. So just running through everything. Let me. Actually, why is it not letting me swap over the talent screen?
Uh-oh.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, there it is.
I was just brain farting. I'm looking at the bottom where the game time is. I'm like, why is the button not there? Right. Oh, man, it's been a long day.
It's all one giant blue screen.
I mean, Rhaegar went to full-on esports style that we have competitive right now. The only difference that you tend to see for Rhaegar is maybe cleanse at level 7 instead of Blood and Thunder, but this is the standard competitive build. You went the standard Thrall build, very powerful. It's just so good for laning in early game, and late game it's got that burst. I went a pretty standard Zagara build. Obviously spell shield isn't all that common, but it saved my life several times, so I have no complaints.
Very true.
Multi-shot is pretty much normal. Tumble makes no sense though. Usually you should see blood for blood. Gifts are so much more dueling potential at level 16.
Should take repeating arrow though to take with tumble. I guess that was her thought, just have more burst.
Yeah, but if you're not specking into Hungering Arrow, other than those two talents, I don't see the point. You're not getting the lifesteal, you're not getting the extra smack. It just seems kind of like inefficient.
Yeah, because I mean, she could, I guess, multi-shot and then.
Yeah, I mean, I get the idea. Arrow. It's just, it's not optimal. There's a damage loss for sure when you go that style.
Fair enough.
Stitches is a. It's not a common build. It's just kind of a hybrid supporty, like sustain utility overall. And then I think everyone else is pretty much what you would expect. Karazim is a full support. That Li Ming actually went a super safe build. That's why the damage was low. It's a teleport build. And teleport build was probably one of the lesser choices for this scenario. Usually we see S of Johan with Seeker, and then you go for Glass Cannon at 13 and you go for Mirror Ball at 16, and she can just one shot people with that build.
Yeah, this is the build that I heard Tia talking about with the coach for the esports team for Elevate, and he was talking about this build's like the now you see me, now you're dead build, which you have to get like super in. And you would actually take her other ult, not to disintegrate. So you would like blink, knock them black, blink again. And roll your combo between each of the two of them, but
yeah, it's cool. It's really hard to execute though. It's a very high skill.
I agree. I would imagine. I want to see it in pro play. Like, it's like the Lee Sin mechanics of Heroes of the Storm, like the displacements and moving and so much fast. Yeah. A lot of APM, I suppose.
Yeah, definitely. I think the thing that was the most interesting about that game, though, is just Sonya going for a Merc build. Now, obviously, collecting Mercs on that map gets you a lot of coins, and coins nets you turn-ins. And it worked really well for them early game, but in those team fights late game, that was a big part of why they just couldn't take the fights, because Sonya was their lone warrior, and she didn't really have any control. Like, unless you're, like, a king of body blocking, Sonya doesn't offer a whole lot of control for that backline, and when you've got Kael'thas and Li Ming, they need control.
Because she took Berserker to go right. Mercs, yeah.
And Merc Lord, and she's just kind of went a pushing style of Sonya, which is cute, but she should have been in Illidan's spot, and they should have had a primary tank to make something like that work.
Just noticed that Kael'thas didn't actually take he took the Felon Fusion to heal himself, but he didn't take Mana Shield.
Yeah, Backdraft can be really powerful if you think you have Blow Up, and I kind of like Backdraft paired with Li Ming, just because like it's going to give you a lot of control for big AoE damage, and that can allow Li Ming to not have to upgrade her Disintegrate at 20, because the 60% slow at 20 is phenomenal, but Tal'Rasha's Elements just empowers her more across the board.
Right.
So it's cool. It's a cool stylistic choice. I'm not against it myself.
I just didn't notice it in the game, because normally when you jump on a Kael'thas, it all of a sudden comes like a 4,000 HP shield. Yeah, so, but
it's kind of a good talent.
That didn't happen. And they both took Gathering Power. I'm really awkward on Gathering Power, because it always feels like once you die like once mid-game, it's like the whole talent is useless from then on.
Yeah, it's high risk, high reward. Definitely did not work for them in that series.
Yeah, a little more for Zeratul. He only died three times, but Kael'thas had seven, so...
Yeah, that's brutal.
We'll have to see. Well, Jake, thank you so much for the end of the game. I think we'll definitely play some more in the future.
Here sounds good.
And there, and good luck with all of the casting in the future.
Thank you.
And thank you all for watching. Hit that like button if you want to see more of this series. Helps me out a great deal. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. And then all of Jake's info is in the description box if you want to go check out his stuff and his stream and his casting.
Yeah.
And I will see you all in the next adventure.
GG's.